Good morning,
Foreign Affairs Council, an important day. I've just been to open our new situation room in Kortenberg, a good example of bringing together the different resources from different parts of the European Union institutions so that we can not only monitor what's happening, but we can support our missions and our delegations more effectively. It's a good example too of cost effectiveness, because it didn't cost a single euro more. But today we'll be discussing, amongst other important issues, the Middle East peace process. I'll be reporting back from the quartet meeting in Washington last week. We'll be, of course, reflecting again on our southern neighborhood. I was in Istanbul for the contact group on Libya, and we'll be discussing Syria and other issues of the region. Growing concern about the levels of violence, growing concern to make sure that our response to the people of Egypt and Tunisia is as good as it can be. The new task force to be set up, Bernardino Leon, who's our special representative for that area, starts work this week. Over lunch as well, to return to Afghanistan and Pakistan. Very important countries, seriously important issues to be debated about how we make sure that we're supporting the people of Afghanistan into the future. We have a lot of development work going on. And to think about how we develop relationships with Pakistan at what is probably a crucial time for them.
High Representative, for Syria, the European Union is accused that he did react quickly when it was to Libya, and when it came to Syria, is taking things slowly.
I don't think that's true at all. I think the European Union has done exactly what it should do. We have a delegation still on the ground. They're working with local people. They're talking to as many people as they possibly can. I've been in touch with the foreign minister. We've done our démarches. We're working with our member states at the Security Council, which is, of course, a really important part of what we do. We're trying to offer as much support as possible. We've been in touch with Turkey, discussing with them how to support the refugees who are coming over the border. We've made it absolutely clear that we think this violence has to stop immediately, and the dialogue, which I'd hoped was going to be real but clearly isn't because of the lack of involvement of the opposition groups, should get going. So I think we have been as active as we can be.
Will the blood increase of Libya?
Hang on, let's go there and there and there. Okay.
Do you think it would be sort of a diplomatic tragedy for the European Union if the Palestinians are not going to the issue of statement to the vote of the
No, I don't think it's a diplomatic tragedy for us, and we don't yet know what the resolution will be. Not surprisingly, we're in touch with the Palestinians to discuss with them what is happening. We're still working on the quartet to see whether we can pull together a statement. It's not easy because the purpose of this statement is to get the talks going again, so it needs to be very inclusive. Excuse me.
Could there be a defreeze of Libyan assets?
A defreeze of Libyan assets. It's down to member states to look at how best they can support the people of Libya. You will know that at the contact group, the United States decided to recognize the Transitional National Council. I think they'll be then able to support them in other ways now. And member states are looking at what they can do.
Are you going to support the announcing of Palestinian state in the UN?
Well, the UN is about individual states, not about regional groupings. So it will be for individual states to make their decisions about any resolution before the UN. But we don't yet know what that resolution will be, and we're in discussions, because the critical thing for me is a Palestinian state in reality. And that means getting the talks moving and getting a resolution to this. So I'm putting all my energy into that. I'm going to go over there. I'll come back.
Lady Aston.